Clelin Ferrell in his debut. Really, really excited to see what this kid did. So I gave him an A grade. Clelin overall, I think, did what he needed to do. Played pretty solid. Was able to hit the quarterback a few times. Was able to get a few tackles. But overall, really showed his upside. Another player that I want to talk about, Maxx Crosby, my dude. Maxx Crosby was everywhere. And if there was one player who was really hyping up the defense, it was Maxx Crosby. So, Maxx, I'm giving you an A-minus grade here. I'm going to be a little tougher on you because you're my homeboy. Six tackles for Maxx Crosby. Really, though, was all over the field. And his motor is absolutely insane. Maxx, the entire time, though, he's telling the entire black hole to get hyped up. Maxx, hell of a game, my man. Benson Mayowa. Dude, Benson Mayowa, my man. If you don't give Benson Mayowa an A-plus grade, get the hell out of here. This guy played absolutely fantastic. Now, he didn't get as much playing time as Clelin. Didn't get as much playing time as Maxx Crosby. But when he was on the field, the dude showed up. He played in 39% of the Raiders' snaps. And he recorded two of Oakland's three sacks. He is the first Raider with two sacks in the game since Khalil Mack. Not saying Benson Mayowa is Khalil Mack, but I am saying this. I'm saying you could see the depth for the Raiders on that defensive line. You could see how fresh some of these players were. And the fact that Benson, when he was coming in that NASCAR package, he was really able to just get after the quarterback. And man, I'll tell you this right now. You get two sacks on Joe Flacco, Benson. That's an A-plus for me every single day. Let's go to Josh Mauro. Josh had a pretty solid game, so that's why I gave him a B grade. But let me know, guys, what you guys are giving all these players grades. So Abram, I see you. Mike, I see you. But Josh Mauro, you get a B from me. Let's go to Mo Hurst now, friend of the show. Mo played well. So again, I'm going to give Mo a B grade. Played good. When these guys needed to show up, they did. And I think one of the reasons why the Raiders were able to control this game is simply because Phillip Lindsay couldn't really get much going. Royce Freeman couldn't get much going because guys like Mo Hurst and because like Jonathan Hankins were showing up and really able to clog up some of these running lanes. So what would you guys grade Jonathan Hankins? Before I give you my grade, what would you guys give Jonathan Hankins? Very, very curious what you guys have to say here. I don't think he played as well as Mauro, and I don't think he's played as well as Mo. So I'm going to give Hankins a B-minus grade. I thought he was able to clog up running lanes when he needed to. But also, I don't think he had quite the motor that Mo Hurst did. So I'm seeing a lot of Bs in the comments section. So we're definitely on the same page there. And then also from Leo, maybe watching a little bit later, getting that FAB. I'm all about it. Let's go to PJ Hall. PJ Hall. Thought he played okay. So I gave him a C grade. What do you guys think? Too rough? Good enough? Not sure? PJ Hall. One player who I'll say straight up, I was hoping for a little bit more out of, was Arden Key. I was hoping for a little bit more out of Arden. He didn't get as much playing time, but I also think it's because he wasn't showing up like he did in the preseason. So for me, I'm going to give Arden Key a C grade. I thought when he was on the field, he didn't have the motor that a player like Clelin Ferrell had or a player like Maxx Crosby had. So Arden Key, you get a C. Let's go to Tahir Whitehead now. Whitehead, last season, right, he's had three straight years with over 100 tackles. He's averaged 123 tackles, but he played pretty solid in this game, so I'm going to give him a B-plus grade. What's the way that you can stop the Broncos' offense is you can control the running game. And I thought Whitehead was flying all over the field, making some clutch tackles. He ended up finishing the game with six tackles, which is why I'm going to give Whitehead a B-plus grade. So make sure you guys comment on the show. Who was the defensive MVP? Comment below. Who was our defensive MVP? I'm very, very curious what you guys have to say. We've had a lot of players play solid. So who was the defensive MVP for the Oakland Raiders in this game? You could say Lamarcus Joyner, Karl Joseph, Clelin Ferrell, Benson Mayowa. I'm seeing a lot of people say Jonathan Abram. I'm seeing Josh Mauro, Conley. Conley's okay. We'll get into a little bit more on that in just a second. But make sure you guys comment below who was the defensive MVP. Let's go to Vontaze Burfict now. Vontaze was a player who I was really excited the Raiders went out and got simply because he knows this defense. So for me, I'm giving Vontaze a B grade. He finished the game with six tackles, which you'll see here in a little bit as amongst the leaders here for the Raiders. But also, he was that defensive leader. You could tell that he knew the defense, and people were looking to him in case they got confused out there. And adding a player of Vontaze Burfict's level of knowledge of this defense is a big reason why they played well. Let's go to Markell Lee. Markell Lee, I told everyone that, hey, the Broncos, they're going to try to run these under crossing patterns, and Markell needs to be a little bit better in the passing game. So Markell didn't get as much playing time as these other guys. So Markell Lee, you get a C grade. Let's talk about Nicholas Mauro now. Mauro, another player, didn't get as much playing time, but I thought when he was on the field, he did actually look pretty solid. So, Nicholas, you get a B grade. So, B for Burfict, C for Lee, B for Mauro. Let me know in the comments section what y'all have to say. And if you see below, Noti Gang, it means you got to click that big red bell, become a part of the notification gang, so you know exactly when we go live. So, let's look at the tackle leaders versus the Broncos. Karl Joseph led the team with 7, then Joyner, Whitehead, Burfict, and Crosby, all with 6 tackles. Really excited to see my guy showing up. Young talent here. Karl Joseph continues to play well. Last year, played well down the end of the stretch and continues that strong play. I'm telling you right now, the defense, if you're not excited about it, you didn't even watch the game. Also, I have an incredible deal for everyone who's watching the show. Chatsports.com/bet. Go to BetDSI. Use that promo code Raiders120 for 120% deposit bonus. BetDSI, they've hooked us up with the best deal out there. Chatsports.com/bet. If anybody goes and does this, hit me up on Twitter. It's there below, at MitchellRen365, that you signed up, and I'm going to give you guys a shout-out on the show. BetDSI, they're helping us out. And also, I want to help you guys out. Get some free money. Go bet on the Raiders, because Raiders got a tough game coming up here against the Chiefs. Let's talk about Gerrion Conley. First off, Gerrion Conley has already been a report out. When he left the field, he gave a thumbs up, and Gerrion is actually looking like he has a chance to play against the Chiefs, which obviously we know is very important against that offense. So for me, I'm going to give Gerrion a B. I thought he started a little bit slow, but actually kind of held Emmanuel Sanders in check, because as soon as Gerrion Conley went out, they started to exploit Trayvon Mullen a little bit. Let's talk about Daryl Worley. Worley, I thought, played okay as well. That's why I gave him a B grade. I think this is the issue with Worley. There were certain plays he just kind of took plays off, which I wasn't too excited about. But Worley, Conley, they both get Bs. And Trayvon Mullen. You guys are going to get mad at me, I think, for giving this grade, but this is me just being real with you. So for the over 800 people who are watching us right now on YouTube and for over the 150 people watching on Facebook, don't get mad at me, but I'm going to give Trayvon Mullen an F. And I'm giving him an F because Emmanuel Sanders was roasting him. He gave up the only touchdown for the team. He gave up that deep ball by Emmanuel. I thought he looked a little bit skittish, and I thought he played a little bit scared. I know Trayvon Mullen is a great player, and I know that if he sees this grade, he's going to get motivated. But I'm telling you right now, Trayvon, you need to play a little bit better. And yes, Emmanuel Sanders is a good receiver, but you got a really tough test, especially if Gerrion can't play next week against the Chiefs. So I took a lot of pictures this week. So if you guys want to get on the show, tweet or post on your Instagram, and all you got to do is just tag me, okay? Tag me in it, at MitchellRen365. I want to take all these pictures, and I want to be able to put them on the show. So I took a bunch of them. I visited a lot of people and a lot of tailgates. I was tailgating in D-Lot with the black hole. Man, I went through all the lots, met a lot of awesome people, ate a lot of freaking awesome food, did some shotguns and some beers, probably drank a little bit too many. But if you have a picture with me that we took this weekend, tweet it or post it on your Instagram story and just hit me up on IG or on Twitter at MitchellRen365. Let's go to some week one, continue with these week one grades. Let's talk about Lamarcus Joyner. I wanted the Raiders to put Joyner up against Emmanuel Sanders because I thought it would have been able to fit better. But Lamarcus, to me, played well, and he really worked in that slot. So Lamarcus Joyner, you get an A- grade from me. I was excited that he was able to make a lot of clutch tackles. And overall, I was excited that he is that Swiss Army knife. That's going to make our defense much different. Let's go to Jonathan Abram now. Abram, to me, likes to lay the wood. And I'm going to give Abram a B grade simply because he needs to be a little bit smarter. Now, I'm not going to put the blame on him for the Gerrion Conley injury because that's not fair. But, like, he's headhunting a little bit. And I think in certain moments, he needs to take it back just a step, calm down, because we know he's a great player. Now, let's talk about Karl Joseph. Karl Joseph had a really, really good game, led the team with 7 tackles, which is why I'm giving him an A grade. Now remember, continue to get your grades in here for every single one of these players. And then, once after these, we're going to use hashtag graders. We're going to do a live Q&A. Let's talk about Jon Gruden now. Jon Gruden. Thought he came out. Thought he executed the game plan well. That's why I'm going to give Jon Gruden an A- grade. I was impressed with his level of knowledge of the team and putting people in the right situation. Greg Olsen. Great job, Greg Olsen. Another guy who I thought had the offense working, but I gave the offense a B. That's why I'm going to give Greg Olsen another B grade. I thought he put the players like Hunter Renfro, Ryan Grant in certain situations when they needed to play well. Paul Guenther. Paul Guenther, hands down, gets an A grade from me. That defense showed up. The defense knew what they were doing. Sure, I understand it's only Joe Flacco and it's the Broncos, but that's a tough Monday Night Football game with a lot of moving pieces. And with all this AB drama, FAB in the comment section, Paul Guenther really, really played well. He got this defense ready, and I was really, really impressed overall how they looked. So get your grades in, all right? Raiders versus the Broncos, A, B, C, D, or F. Let me know in the comment sections if you're watching on YouTube, if you're watching on Facebook. Grade the Raiders week one versus the Denver Broncos. And if you want to know what I think, not going to make you DM me. I'm giving them an A because we just won, baby. Raider Nation, what's going on? Is this the number one Raiders channel on YouTube? For Chucky Heads, believe it, baby. And if you haven't already, subscribe right here. I'm giving you Chucky Heads news, rumors, Raider Nation rumors. And look at this. I'm making your life easier. Check out my next video. Thanks for watching, and go Raiders.